Utah has a lot of unique plants and animals, all thanks to the very diverse terrain, but some of those species are in danger. The Bureau of Land Management says that they're managing about 42 threatened or endangered species in our state right now. Amanda Gilbert spoke with the Department of Wildlife Resources about some of the species native to Utah they are working to protect.
Utah's noticed for its beautiful, diverse landscapes. But what about its animals on that land? Like the Utah prairie dogs, you can spot their white-tipped tails.
I also happen to think they're really cute. They're fun to watch.
Recovery biologist Barbara Sugarman counts these social creatures. She says they've been endangered for years since they like to live where we like to live, and plague's a big concern.
Some fleas that are carrying plague will come into a colony, and within a few days, it's not uncommon for every single individual in that colony to be dead.
They're now just threatened instead of endangered. Like the Utah prairie dogs, the DNR is keeping a close eye on the greater sage-grouse bird.
It's truly a symbol of the West.
Scott Root with the Utah Division of Wildlife Resources has captured video of them in our lakes.
And a male will gulp air, just and go whoop, whoop, whoop.
He says they too have factors against them, like predators and habitat loss.
But the sage grouse is a big priority for us. We want to know where they're going, what's their predation rate, how many are getting killed.
In the air, right now, the California condor is important to highlight because recently here in Utah, the avian flu took out some of this endangered species.
They found about 20 condor mortalities over the last couple months.
There's only a few hundred in our state. From land to water, biologist Andrew Nagy studies the June suckerfish, which she says is found in only one place in the whole world.
And that place is our very own Utah Lake and the tributaries that flow into it.
Once endangered in the 1980s,
there were thought to be less than 1,000 individual June sucker left.
It's now a threatened species. Sport Fish Project Leader Mike Slater says hatcheries work to keep the June suckers from disappearing, so there's not a repeat of what happened to the Utah Lake sculpin.
You know, a little tiny fish. Used to be in Utah Lake, but it's no more.
So why should we care about these threatened or endangered species?
Everybody should care about every species. And when they get to lower populations, we have to step in and make them a priority.
Root adds our native Utah species.
They've always been here before we got here.
It's important to care about them just as much as we care about our state and national parks.